In this video, I'm going to talk about ozonolysis of cycloalkene. So here we have our alkene, and that reacts with our ozone molecule here, and we form two double bonds between carbon and oxygen atoms in presence of our solvent dimethyl sulfide. The formula of dimethyl sulfide is this one here. Now, before going into any details, this is the resonance form of the ozone molecule, where you can literally see that one of the oxygen atoms will be having a positive formal charge and other will be having a negative formal charge, and that can resonate each other to be any of these two forms. Now let's talk about the mechanism. So first of all, you can see that our alkene and our ozone molecule come closer together, where our negative formal charge or negatively charged oxygen atom will attack our carbon atom here. So that will definitely shift this pi electron towards this carbon, and so it will attack this oxygen atom here, and that will leave the electrons of this double bond here onto this oxygen atom. So that will definitely form a compound named monozonide, where you can see that this carbon atom is bonded with this oxygen atom, and this carbon is bonded with this oxygen atom, and these oxygen atoms are already bonded before. So now what happens here is that one of these lone pairs of electrons on the oxygen atoms will try to reform a double bond with this carbon atom. So this bond between the carbon and carbon will break and will form a double bond between carbon and oxygen atom. So that will definitely break this bond between oxygen and oxygen, and will leave on this oxygen atom as a lone pair of electron. So we'll be having our this intermediate here, where we have our double bond between carbon and oxygen here, and carbon and double bond between oxygen here. As we have to remember that this oxygen has two lone pairs of electrons, but after forming a double bond with this carbon atom here, it will be leaving with a positive formal charge here. Cool. So in the next step, what we'll be seeing here is that we know that there is a distinct difference in the electronegativity between carbon and oxygen atoms. So these carbon and oxygen atoms will form a partial positive and partial negative charge on it. And this negatively charged oxygen atom will act as a nucleophile, where our this carbon atom here will act as an electrophile. So this will attack this carbon atom here and will try to form a bond between carbon and oxygen here. So definitely this double bond will break down, and this electron will attack here at this carbon atom, and so this double bond will also break eventually and will form and will leave the electrons onto this oxygen atom and will nullify this positive charge on this oxygen atom. So we'll be forming a bond between carbon and oxygen here. Let me show it with the color. So here and here we have a carbon and oxygen two single bonds here, and we'll be forming another bond between this carbon and oxygen here, and this bond was there before. Now at this certain stage, we'll be introducing our solvent dimethyl sulfide, as our sulfur atom will have its own fair share of lone pairs of electrons. It will attack this oxygen atom here, so this comparatively weaker oxygen and oxygen bond will break down here and will form a double bond between this carbon and this oxygen atom. As this carbon atom cannot have more than four bonds, so this bond will move towards this particular bond, where this carbon atom will form a double bond with this oxygen atom. here, right? And so obviously this bond between carbon and oxygen will break and will leave the electrons onto this oxygen atom as a lone pair. So you can clearly see that there is a bond between oxygen and sulfur, where our oxygen has a negative formal charge because it had four electrons before. Now it has six after getting two more electrons from this bond. So, and we'll be having a double bond between this carbon and oxygen atoms here, and we'll be having another double bond between this carbon and oxygen here, and later on this negative charge can form a double bond between this oxygen and sulfur atom, which is called dimethyl sulfoxide, and we'll be leaving with our final product here, that is the ozonolysis reaction here, and I hope you guys have understood.